on this floor were some offices and some classrooms. Years ago, guidance offices were through this way. Our superintendent, Dr. Circle, and the principal of the junior high school, Dr. Pellico, their offices were back through this way where it says bathroom. Their offices were not the bathroom, but that's just where their offices were. If you walk down the hallway here, I'm going to show you a kindergarten classroom, so follow me. Kindergarten classroom was here at Glenside Weldon. Notice the small water fountain here and, also take a look at the very small toilets here. Kindergarten classroom years ago. Kindergarten would be out here on the blacktop. This was a dedicated kindergarten play area out here. Then you would attend Glenside Weldon English classroom.
This is my kindergarten.
Was it really?
Yeah. Lobby of the lower building. Schools across the district and housed grades K through 6. When the district experienced
and enrollment declined largely in North Hills. Elementary schools were closed. If you notice the bell that's in the corner here, that bell was from the North Hills Elementary School. The Glenside Weldon bell is still located in the bell tower. And both bells will be saved as artifacts along with several other items such as, you know, pieces from the facade, the GW that's located outside of the building, as well as the 1906 and 1924.
Someone on the last tour told me that right here in the center lobby, it would be a really tall Christmas tree, and children would make ornaments.
And
you look back over here,
you'll see an old cloakroom. I guess many of you remember.
That's where you put your
pants. Didn't necessarily behave yourself in class. Maybe some of you were sent to the cloakroom.
Very big. Tall ceilings. Look how tall the ceilings are. And the doors, too. I mean,
they look ancient. Anyone's classroom?
This one was my first grade.
Okay.
Yeah.
So get in there. It's probably not locked.
They're probably all locked down. Yep. Yep. Pretty cool.
As we walk through this elevated corridor along the back of the cafeteria, that's where we'll return when we go to the end of our tour. This section was built, the cafeteria was built in 1954. When the school was operational, there were several sittings of students for lunch, and the passageway with the cafeteria to this side of me and the courtyard to the back of me, students would exit the cafeteria and go out this way for recess. And this was built as the connector between the lower buildings and the upper building. As we walk on to the other side, this is the upper building. Down this hallway, you'll note to your left the health suite. Please note the round windows on the health room door.
Thank you.
just tell Melford to bring him upstairs when you bring the dog.
There? Yeah. Ram him on that doorway and I would be down here.
Yo, does your class have to line up at recess today?
I gotta stay in.
Are you serious?
Yes, me too. Did you come?
I did.
Yeah.
I was here, yeah.
But you're much younger than us.
Well, if we went to school with her parents, yeah, I think she's a bit younger.
She's our daughter.
Serving grades 7 through 9. Glenside Weldon was originally one of three junior high schools in the district serving the entire school district before the creation of North Campus in the 80s, which later became Abington Junior High School. The upper building housed later on grades 4, 5, and 6, and the lower buildings housed grades K through 3. The office across the hallway here used to be the entrance to the auditorium. Does anybody here remember that? That this was the entrance to the auditorium?
Yeah. And then there was a balcony upstairs.
Yeah, the balcony upstairs was later turned into a computer lab.
Yeah.
And we'll walk into the library and we'll show you how that looks. The mosaic tiles that are over here were made and donated by Glenside Weldon class 2000.
Oh, I was wondering.
Who remembers this one?
What does that say? Thank you.
This is all huge.
Yeah, Michael, if you look up, you can see. You see how high it goes up.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's unbelievable. Mm-hmm. And they'd be packed. They used to do the plays.
At least it seemed big to us anyway. I remember it big, yeah.
Well, you know, it's amazing how your perspective changes. Like, you know, from elementary school when you leave. I can't imagine how small things.
Yeah, I see.
And then on both floors, there was windows. If you went up and you could actually.
When the library was first put in, was the floor sunken here? Was there a pit there?
Yeah,
there's
a pit.
That's, I thought I saw a photo of that at one point. Okay, cool.
Balcony above the library here was converted into a computer lab, and the elevated area in the rear of the library was actually the stage of the auditorium. And in today's world, you'll notice that classrooms are a lot bigger than this classroom. Also, you'll see that the technology of this type of classroom is nowhere near or does not necessarily meet the needs of today's classroom.
Mrs. Swoos, oh yeah.
I remember when we used this building, I just remember classrooms on this side that were right next to this roof.
Yep.
Would get so hot.
Yep. Oh yeah, when, especially that late in the day.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, yeah.
So they would try to keep the glare out with the pull downs. Yeah. Yeah, it would get a weird glare. You're right. Yeah, it was real uneven depending on where you were at.
Yeah. Yeah.
They did such a good job of replicating the original in the newer building. Like, you get turned around.
Yeah.
You, wait, which one?
going to go back down the stairs down here to my left, and we're going to go back down to the cafeteria. I want to thank you for hanging out with me. Thank you for allowing me to be your tour guide through Glenside Weldon. Appreciate hearing all the stories. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Please be sure that you stop by the memory table that's located in the back of the cafeteria. Also, the Old York Road Historical Society has a long table set up in the cafeteria with a lot of Glenside Weldon memorabilia at that table, like yearbooks and things like that. So please be sure to stop by.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Last time you step out of a GW classroom. And that one is nice and cool. Thanks again.
Thank you. Have a good day.
You as well.